Hey everyone, happy Sunday and welcome back. Today I am going to be talking to you guys about a week one ultimate reset recap. So I just wrapped up week one. Friday was the last day and I am completely blown away by how great I'm feeling during the ultimate reset. I tried to set out to do the ultimate reset, as most of you know, last year, but then on day two, I found out I was pregnant, so I stopped because I freaked out, and I was like, I'm stopping right now, blah, blah, blah. Nick, however, kept going without me, ended up losing 20 pounds in 21 days, and now he has joined me back doing the reset. I'll link his channel down below so you can check out his videos. He just posted his week one recap, so I recommend checking that out because I think we've had slightly different experiences, especially with how we started. So like I said, I just wrapped up week one, and as far as week one goes, I haven't done my measurements yet. I probably will do them at the end of week two just because I got so busy, but I lost 4 pounds the first week. I'm very excited. I am definitely feeling a lot different. I feel lighter. You know how sometimes like when you wake up in the morning and you kind of just, you feel lighter. You just feel like there's less weight on you. Compared to, you know, some days you wake up and you feel kind of like crappy and sluggish and down. All week I've been waking up feeling well rested. I have been feeling amazing, lighter. No weird dreams yet. I remember Nick talking about that the last time around, that he had weird dreams, and I've heard it from other people because your body's just doing so much work internally that your brain's just going, woo! But I don't think I've had any weird dreams. I haven't even really remembered my dreams lately, I don't think. So that's kind of funny. But I've been having really good sleep, waking up well rested. I'm pretty much getting up at the same time every day, which on the days I want to sleep in kind of stinks, but I feel like my internal clock is going really well pretty much when the sun wants to come up, my body wants to get up and it's ready to go. And actually, the first day I would say was the roughest because I had a really long day on day one, but pretty much every other day has been better. And I honestly haven't felt hungry. I'm eating a significantly less food than I'm normally used to, especially before I got on the healthy train. This is like a crazy amount less food. But I don't find myself that hungry. And now as I'm sitting here on day nine, I'm not thinking about food and like craving it as much as I used to. I find that with the ultimate reset, not only do you lose weight, you clean out internally and feel better. I feel like you learn a lot about food and your triggers and all that, because before I feel like even though I've been eating a lot healthier, I would spend a great deal of my day when I wasn't eating or preparing a meal, planning out the next one, thinking about what it was going to taste like. And I feel like I spent a lot of time consumed in my day, in my mind at least, thinking about food. And I know that, you know, we want to enjoy food, we want to enjoy what we're eating, but at least with me personally, I found that it wasn't that I was just looking forward to it. I feel like it was partially like all I thought about, which definitely wasn't good for me. And I feel like now on day nine, I'm really not screaming baby. He probably just wants Nick to pick him up. But I just feel like now on day nine, I'm not as consumed in food. And I feel like now I'm able to spend a lot more energy on other things. I'm putting a lot more time into my business and planning. I'm finishing up my clean eating guide that I'm sharing with some of my participants. Well, not sharing with some of them, giving to all of my clean eating challenge participants. So if you want more information about my clean eating challenge starting next month in May, send me a message. I'm reading a lot more, which is nice. I'm doing a lot more research on nutrition, which I'm learning a lot more about it, which is really exciting. And as far as like, I'm learning about nutrition, but it's not just around like food and meals. It's around like learning like different ingredients and what's good and what's, you know, what research is showing is not good. I'm looking into a lot more about GMOs and all that. So I feel like because I'm not so consumed in thinking about and dreaming about my next meal, that I've been able to have so much more time to actually accomplish things. So that's definitely something I know I'll have to continue to work on getting over. I have a lot of energy. I don't really hit that 2 o'clock crash. I find I'm not really yawning as much, unless someone I'm with is yawning. Then of course, you know, yawning's contagious, so you do it too. But you know, I was out late last night, and you know, yeah, you get a little bit sleepy, but I wasn't tired. Like I probably still could have kept on going, which is, I think it has a lot to do with, you know, the reset, what I'm doing, and I feel like I'm definitely thinking a lot clearer. I feel like I have a lot more mental clarity. I'm able to plan something and follow through and not really get distracted and caught up. I don't really know how to describe it, but I feel less fuzzy. And yeah, I mean, I'm loving it, guys. I am absolutely loving the reset. The meals are great. I haven't cheated other than maybe like taking one thing out of one meal and putting it in another and maybe having my snack later in the day when I should have had it earlier, but little things like that. Other than that, I'm following it great. I love it. I probably should drink a little bit more water, but I'm just running around all the time and sometimes it's hard to grab water, but thankfully Nick has my back and will be like, here, drink some water. So I'm very thankful for that. Look out for a recap on week two. As far as my goals for week two, I want to continue to stick to the plan. I want to learn more about myself and my triggers in regards to nutrition so I can overcome them and continue to make better decisions after the reset. And of course, I'm hoping I'll drop a couple more pounds. I'll probably do measurements after week two just to kind of see. But detox isn't really that bad. I don't want to ruin anything for you guys. Look for my week two recap. And if you want any more information about the Ultimate Reset, email me at k@kfitness.com. Send me a Facebook message or comment down below. I would love to talk to you about it. If you want to check out the reset for yourself as well, the link is down below. Like I said, guys, I highly recommend it. It's not hard. I feel like when you want something and you commit to it, it gets so much easier to do it. And I feel like when people kind of slide and they don't quite, you know, when they don't quite want to follow it, it's because they just, in their mind, they don't want to finish it. And I feel like when you fully commit to something, to doing it, finishing it is so much easier. So if you really want to commit to losing weight, feeling better, cleaning everything out, and just completely just revamping how you feel about nutrition, I feel like the reset is absolutely perfect for you. I'd love to work with you on it. Again, links are down below. Send me a message and I'll see you guys next time.